In this shoemaking tutorial, we will talk about Sockliner. I already made a tutorial where I teach how to make this important detail of our footwear professionally working with shoe last, exactly as I teach in my courses. But today, in this tutorial, I want to show you something different. I want to show you the way how you can replace your old Sockliner on your footwear that you made or maybe you purchased and make the new one. Maybe this Sockliner made from bad materials or just not comfortable or old and you want to replace it. So in this tutorial, on example of these kid shoes, I will teach you how you can make new Sockliner working with materials that you want to use. On example of these kid shoes, I will show you how to replace the Sockliner that we have here inside of our shoes. Sockliner is inner part of our footwear that lays on the insole, and we touch the surface of the Sockliner when we wear our shoes. There are a few types of Sockliners. This one, for example, is removable. If you want to replace the Sockliner that is not removable, you need to take it off, disattach it from the insole. This one also was attached a little bit on the toe, but it was very easy to put it, to take it off and pull it from the shoe. Okay, so I don't like this kind of fabric that is attached on this foam, and that's why I want to replace it with more quality material like leather. This Sockliner has this foam. And instead of this foam, I will use cork, another brilliant natural material that we use a lot in shoemaking, the cork. If you don't have cork, you can use any other foam that you can find in your local store. But before you will choose the foam, you need to observe well the foam that you want to buy, because this one, for example, you see, when I press it, it returns to its original shape. But there are a few types of foam that after you will squeeze it, it will stay flattened. So check this quality of your foam before you will want to buy it, okay? That's why I love cork, because cork is very, it's soft and durable in the same time. Because when I will squeeze it, I feel the softness of this material, but after I squeeze the cork, it returns to its normal shape. It doesn't change the shape, and during wearing it can squeezes and it can be flattened under pressure of your body, but it will take a long time. And foams instead of cork will change its shape much faster than cork. That's why I want actually to replace this foam with cork, and I also will replace the surface of the Sockliner. I don't like this fabric, I will use leather. Okay, so after you will take your Sockliner off from the shoes, you need to make a pattern. So right now we will make a pattern of this Sockliner. To make a pattern, we need to take a piece of cardboard, and we will copy the outline of the Sockliner. This Sockliner looks good, but if you have something old that almost changed the shape, you need to flatten it well on the surface of your cardboard and fix it with few nails. So, for example, like this, you need to take a nail and place it inside of your Sockliner. And it will fix it on the surface of the cardboard. Okay? So, this is how you can work when you have very old Sockliner that doesn't have the clear shape. So, place your Sockliner on the cardboard. And with the pencil, copy the outline of the Sockliner.
This mark that we have here marks the inner side of our footwear. So looking on this mark, you can understand that this sockliner belongs to the right feet. When you will turn it over, you will have the left feet. But according to this mark, you will know how to attach and how to cut sockliners, how to attach them correctly inside of your footwear. So now we have the outline of the sockliner. Make it smooth liner lines. If you have some not a very curved continuation of the line, and now let's cut it out. I will cut it from this big piece of cardboard for more comfortable work. One more suggestion for you is to use knife instead of scissors, because using knife you will have more accurate cardboard patterns and leather patterns, and with knife it's easier to work and cut pieces of cardboard or leather. So after you will copy the line, you need to cut it. Use the inner side of this mark to not enlarge the volume of our sock liner because of the thickness of the pencil, 0.5 millimeters, but it still will enlarge the dimension of our sock liner if we will cut using outer side line of this mark. So that's why during cutting, pay attention how you cut, and cut following the inner side of this mark. You see, I use ordinary utility knife. Nothing special in it. There is You see, I'm trying always to cut using the inner side of this mark. Cut slowly. Do not ruin your work. Okay. Now we have the pattern of this fabric that is attached to the surface of this foam. Now we need to make another pattern of the foam, because they will be with different dimensions. Why? Because it will be much easier to attach leather to the surface of the foam or cork. That's why now I will enlarge it a little bit, and I will have second pattern for the foam or cork. And when I will move on, you will understand why it's easier to have surface of the cork or foam bigger than the surface of your first layer fabric, if you will want to make it from fabric or leather. Okay. So right now we will enlarge this pattern. You can use compasses, or you can do it by eyes as well. I just place it on the cardboard and enlarge it approximately on few millimeters. 1 centimeter is maximum, but don't do it more than 1 centimeter. it's about 7-8 millimeters around. And you see, I don't use any tool here. I do it by eyes because we will cut this extra after we will attach the first layer. In my case, it will be leather. So when I will attach leather to the cork, I will cut the extra according to the edge of the leather. So this is one of the easiest way to make accurate sock liner with layer of cork. And now you see we have here this mark. We can make this mark as well here to know where is our left and right foot, but I will not make this mark because in our cases when we want to make this sock liner only for our footwear, we can understand where the left and where the right feet. This mark uses the most in big productions. Okay, so they know how to cut and how to attach left and right parts of the footwear. Now, if the sock liner that you want to replace doesn't have any foam and it's only thin piece of fabric or leather, you still can improve it and make it with the soft layer. But to not reduce the entire volume of your footwear after you will attach your new sock liner with entire foam, because when you will use this foam or cork, the total volume of your footwear will reduce and you may have smaller footwear because of this foam. So to not make a foam that will cover the entire surface of the sock liner, but still have the soft and comfortable sock liner, you can attach only half of the foam or cork. So this cork layer or foam layer will cover only one half of your sock liner. So here you will have some soft appearance and it will not reduce your footwear because of the thickness of the foam or cork liner or cork that you will attach to your sock liner. So we have here two patterns. First pattern for the layer of material that you will use in your sock liner, and the second pattern is for padding that can be the second layer is for foam or for cork. Okay, so right now let's cut out these materials. So for the first layer, I will use this vegetable tan leather, and you can use any other that you have. For the right foot, I will place the pattern like this. For the left foot, I will turn it over and place it in this way. Okay, but right now I will demonstrate only one half. When you will do it, remember to turn it over and cut your pattern twice. So you see, I didn't copy the outline of the cardboard on the leather. I cut directly. Hold well the pattern with your left hand so the pattern will not move. Sometimes if you have big pieces that we need to cut, we can use something heavy and keep pattern on the same place. Heavy like hammer or any other thing that you have that is heavy, to hold it on the right place. You see, right now I'm cutting from different places because it's not comfortable for me in this position to cut. Usually I need to stand up, but it doesn't important the order. It's important to cut the entire piece. So before you will take off leather, check if you cut everything okay, and then you can take off the pattern. Okay, this first layer. This is the cork. Here you don't need to turn it over because we don't have here face side or back side. And here we can copy the line and cut it because here this pattern has extra that we will cut. So we doesn't change here nothing when we copy the line, the outline, because anyway we will cut the extra. Okay, now we need to attach this leather piece to the cork and cut the extra. So that's why we made here this enlargement for the second layer for the cork, because in this way it's much easier to cut. And if I will have the cork with the same parameters like the first layer, for example, imagine that this is cork, it will be very difficult to attach it accurately where edge of the leather and edge of the cork will match each other. Okay, so that's why it's better to have second layer cork or foam bigger than the first layer. So let's attach these two pieces. Place on both surfaces glue. I use contact glue. Place well glue on entire surface of leather or fabric, of course on the inner side, and on entire surface of your foam or cork. And after you place the glue, wait for 10 or 15 minutes before attaching, before you will attach these two pieces. Okay, so right now we can attach them together and you will see how it's easy, because I don't need to care how I will place it because I have here enough space, and I just place it on the cork. Check well that you see the extra that extends from the first layer. Okay, let's attach it well using hammer. And that's it, almost that's it. Just now, right now, we need to cut the extra of this cork. And how to cut? Use this edge of your first layer as a guideline. That's it. You see, now we have very smooth edge of the our new Sockliner that consists from two materials, leather and cork. And what we need to do is to attach it inside of our shoes. Okay, you can attach it only in the toe area. So place a little glue here on your sock liner part and on the toe of your shoes. If you want to attach entire sock liner, place glue on the entire surface of your sock liner and on the insole, on the entire insole of your shoes, but be careful to not place glue on the sides of your lining of your shoes. Now, what you can do if you don't have on your original sock liner any foam piece, you still can make it with foam, but you can attach your foam not on the entire surface of your sock liner, because in this way you will reduce your footwear because of the thickness of this foam, but you can attach only half, you can attach this foam or cork only on the half of your sock liner. In this way you will have soft part or soft back part of your footwear, and you will add in this way extra comfort to your footwear, but will not change the dimension of your footwear because of the thickness of this foam, and your footwear will be very comfortable. So how to do it? Your same approach, make first layer of sock liner as I showed before, like this pattern, and second, the our foam or cork part, make only half. So when you will copy the line outline of your first layer to create pattern for your sock, for the cork or for the foam, make only half, okay? And half can be, you can make only on the heel part or until the instep. So on your original pattern, mark the line where, until which place will reach the edge of the foam or sock liner. And mark it on the second part of your pattern, on the pattern for the cork, okay? So this is the line. Make here this mark of the line that will be the edge of our cork. So we will know where we need to attach this edge on the first layer of our sock liner, leather or fabric. Okay, and mark this line after you will cut the sock liner from leather, turn it over and mark on the inner part of your sock liner this line. Okay, so you will know where to attach the sock liner, where to attach the foam or cork on your sock liner, because you will have this line, okay? That's it. And second important point in this case, if you will use only half of the cork or foam, let's cut it. So I will show you what you need to do as well. Is you will need to make this edge of our cork or foam a little bit thinner to not feel this step on your feet, because it will feel like step because it has thickness, and when you will wear this sock liner you may feel this edge. So to not feel it, skive it a little bit with your utility knife. If you don't have any special shoemaking knife, skive it to make it thinner. Okay, here we have extra, so we'll still have enough space to attach it. Okay, and then when you will attach this half cork or half foam to the first layer of our sock liner, place it according to the line that you will have, this mark you will have on the inner side of your sock liner and then attach it. We will have here smooth transection between cork and first layer, leather or fabric of our sock liner, because we skived the edge. That's it. This was a tutorial on how you can replace your old sock liners and make beautiful and comfortable new sock liners using the material that you want to use. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you, and see you in the next video. Bye.